Here is the start list of the women's vault, and as well as the men's pommel horse, we have the Olympic champion in the starting field. Number 5 there, Elena Sabalodzikova. She's reigning European, world and Olympic champion. Sabalodzikova, the great Russian girl. Tiny little girl, but such a tremendous vaulter. And some other interesting names, like start number 1, Oksana Shushubetina from Uzbekistan. It's very interesting. She's 25 years old now, mother of a 1.5-year-old child, and three times Olympic participant. Oksana Shushubetina, she was taking part in Sydney while having birth of a child only less than a year before the Sydney Olympics, and taking part and now still competing on a very high international level. That shows a lot of the new era of women's gymnastics, not only for the 14, 15-year-old girls. There's a lot of women 20 years old and even more now at the very highest level. At first, Oksana Shushubetina here in picture from Uzbekistan, competed already in 92 Olympics in Barcelona, where she was one of the members in the winning combined Soviet Republic team who took part there in Barcelona. Now she's competing for her country, Uzbekistan. First vault. Good one. Front spring, 1.5 twist.
Sofort start am Pauschenpferd, Sultan Schokolade.
And there's a new rule with the lines on the mat there. We'll have a look at them later on. Back to vault, and the second vault for Shushubetina. The girls having two vaults in the Apparatus finals, as well as the men have, and the vaults got to be from different vault groups, so it will be quite another vault. Oh yes, it is. This is a Sukahara vault. Let's see in the slow motion.
Und diese junge Dame war bereits
Sukahara full twist. And we didn't see the score for the first vault. We know it had the starting value of 9.8, the first vault, but we didn't see the results. And the final result in vault will be the average of the two performed vaults.
Sultan Schokola, 8.4 am Pauschenpferd. Wir waren die Wertung.
We're waiting for the scores.
Anschließend erster Sprung von Emma Williams, Großbritannien. Die Wertung.
I think we will have the scores before the next one is coming. And then you might have heard the score for Shushubetina, 9.125 was the average score. When the British girl, Emma Williams, is the next one to perform on this piece of apparatus. That's a Chuchenko vault. Oh yes, stepping outside the blue mat, but the line rules are counting at the moment of hitting the mat. Got to be ahead of the first black line, which is 1 meter from the horse, and you got to be inside the corridor, and that's no problems for Emma, even though she's stepping out afterwards. Here are the two best on the vault. Shushubetina in the lead before Emma Williams. And here's the next girl, Lubashnuk, tiny little Russian member of the Olympic team. Well, it's landing very aside of the landing area. Also stepping on the side of the vaulting board. Not straight at all. Well, No, I won't say that's a good vault. No, definitely not for Lubasniuk.
Auch hier sind die Verhältnisse neu geordnet, die Schwierigkeiten neu bestimmt.
Others, the Olympic champion. Lubasniuk then. Back on vault. She has had her first vault. She will do second one before we can give you the result of the vault for this Russian girl.
Der Saison sind schwierig. 8,838 Rang 3 für Martin Fuchs am Pauschenpferd und nun.
In the meantime, while waiting for Lubasniuk, we can give you the score for Martin Fuchs. On Pommel Horse, he had 8.838, giving him third place so far. Well, Lubasniuk then. Second vault for her. Well, starting very well with Yutchenko. Double twist, very high vault, but a little bit under rotated, and she's falling forward on her knees. Here comes the Yutchenko start, going backwards on the horse, pushing with her hands, doing a vault with double twist, but under rotating it, having a fall at the landing. It's not enough. High level of vaults, but you got to perform them well as well, otherwise the score won't be so fine. No, Lubasniuk won't be in the winner's final, I'm quite sure.
Dritte Bronze in Sydney beim Sprung für Ekaterina Lubasniuk, also ein Weltstar. Die Wertung für Sie im Mittel beider Sprünge 8,762 Rang 3. Und jetzt Vorentscheidung.
Lubasniuk, who just performed on vault, was actually number 3. Now she's number 3 as well. She was third in Sydney Olympics, but here you might have seen her score of 8.762. The average score for Lubasniuk, and it's not enough today.
Czech,
Jana Komroskova.
Im belgischen Gent. Sie kann nach den Sternen greifen. Sie gewann ja nicht nur Gold am Sprunggerät in Sydney, sondern
Zuckerhara with double twist. Good vault, actually. Really good.
Moskau.
And this is a girl who made her name last year.
Schauen noch mal auf die. Wertung Pauschenpferd. Da ist die Wertung Pauschenpferd 8,387 Rang 5 für
8.387 for Luja. And the next vault for Samalogikova. Did I call her Komskrova last time? Sorry about that. This is of course the Olympic and world champion on vault, Samalogikova. Oh, an excellent vault. Quite a big step at landing, but so easily performed by Yelena Samalogikova, the Russian vault and floor specialist. Olympic champion last year, she's world champion, she's European champion, she's everything on vault. So early finishing her double twist, stretching out for the landing. Even though she has some problems standing still, it is a world-class vault, and I'm quite sure you will see more of her in the winner's final.
Beim DTB-Pokal in Stuttgart war sie dreifache Siegerin im Herbst.
Here is the next girl. That's a Czech I spoke about before.
9,462 deutlich vor Czesovitina.
Samalogikova, having the score, the average score of 9.462. And it's definitely the highest score so far. 3.5 tenths before Oksana Shushuvitina. And we have Yelena Samolodzhikova for sure in the final, in the winner's final. Challenging maybe Oksana Shushuvitina or maybe this girl, Jana Komskrova. Or some of the two other remaining girls coming after Jana. This is the Czech girl, Jana Komskrova, placing 29th all around at the Olympics. Not really receiving the height she would like to see on the vault, even though she's landing quite well.
Die 17-jährige Jana Komskrova kommt aus Zlin, gleich zu ihrem Meer.
It's a Jutschenko vault with half turn before hitting the horse, then trying to push off and doing a piked vault forward with half twist. And as we said before, we would like to see a little bit more height in the second flight phase. Here we have the scores for the four first girls. We have also seen the Mexican Lopez.
Männer am Pauschenpferd und Damen in Aktion, Finalgerät, Sprung. Wir bitten sofort das Einturnen an diesen Strategen zu dem Newcomer der Saison.
Jana Komskrova denn.
Aus Paris vor 14 Jahren. Tagen kam sie hierher, 15 Jahre alt.
On the vault. Her second vault.
Und kommt aus den Niederlanden, Verona van der Leur.
And this is not the Dutch girl, the speaker, the conferencier is presenting. This is Jana Komskrova. The Czechish girl have her second vault to do. And she was second in Paris 2 weeks ago, meeting Samolodzhikova in the winner's final. Maybe she will do something like that today. Let's have a look. Well, good landing. Also on this second vault for Jana. She's making a handspring, piked front, half twist.
Jana Komskrova. Auch ihr Weg hat erst begonnen. Neben Sprung war sie auch am Barren erfolgreich. War Vierte beim Weltcup-Finale in Glasgow, Vierte auch beim Sprung. Und hier addiert sie den zweiten Sprung dazu und liegt auf Rang 3 mit 9,062 Punkten hinter Samolodzhikova und Shushuvitina.
And there's the score, it's 9.062 for Komskrova, and she's third with that score. She's not in the winner's final today, no, but she's number 3 so far, two more girls to go. And here is a really interesting name, Verona van der Leur from Holland. Only 15 years old, this Dutch girl. She was a junior last year, now stepping up on the senior side. Her first vault. Oh yes, it's good indeed. Jutschenko double twist. And the Dutch gymnastics is really improving on the women's side. They did extremely well on the Europeans last year with the team grabbing the bronze, team with, among others, this girl, Verona van der Leur. She was 11th all around in Bremen, no, sorry, in Paris, where the Europeans for women were held last year. And she's already in Paris 2 weeks ago shown her strength on the senior side. She was there, number 6 on vault, but even better, she won the uneven bars competition there ahead of a lot of world stars. So it will be interesting to see her today as well. Only one more gymnast to go on pommel horse, and second vault for Verona van der Leur here on the women's side. Oops, not so good landing this time. A little bit under rotated.
Na ja, fast. Die Standsicherheit noch, aber gerade mal 15 Jahre alt. Da ist noch viel von diesem jungen Mädchen.
So we said before, only 15 years old. So she has the future ahead of her, definitely.
Haben die Niederländerinnen, wie gesagt, in den letzten Jahren schon vielfach aufmerksam gemacht. Jetzt wachsen sie hinein in ihre großen internationalen Aufgaben, so wie auch der Deutsche Turnerbund.
She was number six in Paris 2 weeks ago in this event.
Neue Ziele anvisiert. Sie wissen, der
Olympiazyklus hat begonnen. And I think it would be something like that here as well, maybe a little bit better.
Nach Athen 2004. Über die Stationen Gent 2001 und die wichtige Weltmeisterschaft.
Actually 0 points here for
Qualifikation für Olympia 2 Jahre später.
Second vault, could that be right?
Van der Leur im Mittel 9,038 Punkte, Rang 4 hinter Kommissar.
Must be some wrong there with that sign, because my notes, and I have a score, average score of 9.038 for Verona van der Leur. 9.038, and she's number 4 so far, with one more girl to go. On vault, last one on this rotation. This is Lisa Brüggemann from Germany. Oops. Well, it looked a little bit unsteady from the beginning. Might be a new vault for her. Look here, 16-year-old German girl is doing a Jutschenko vault, but she's already twisting before the vaulting board, not putting the feet as it's supposed to be. So she's not really mastering this vault. And, as you can see, or you will see, the score won't be that good either. Starting the twist too early, not waiting for the push from the vaulting board. Doing a quarter turn already while doing the round off on the floor.
In Tianjin. Jetzt die Wertung hier. 8,475. Bleiben wir beim Deutschen Turnerbund.
What a success for Sven Kwiatkowski in front of the home crowd. He was number 4 2 weeks ago in Paris, now he's number 2 in this another World Cup competition here in Cottbus. We'll see him soon in the winners' final. Second vault for Lisa Brüggemann then. There's the handspring pike front half twist. We've seen it before.
Na, da gab sie doch die Bestätigung, dass es doch geht und gehen kann.
Not so bad. Better than the last vault she did.
Sie hatte
definitely
vorige Woche erst eine weite Reise hinter sich gebracht. In Pottsville in den USA gewann sie das Sprunggerät dort und holte Silber am Boden und war Dritte im Mehrkampf bei den Friendship Classics.
Good vault there
also
for
die Wettkampfstabilität war es wohl
Lisa Brüggemann
zu diesem Zeitpunkt.
Zum and they're waiting for the last score of this rotation before we will see the winners' final in just a couple of minutes. On the women's vault and the men's pommel horse. Here's Lisa Brüggemann, 8.7 on the second vault, makes, 8.95, and an average score of 8.713 gives her place number 7. And then it's clear it will be Samolodchikova against Shushovutina in the winners' final for women vault. Final, the two best, Jelena Samolodchikova and Oksana Shushovutina, will now compete once again, meeting each other in the winners' final. Before we can say who is the gold medal winner, will it be this girl, Jelena Samolodchikova, a reigning Olympic and world champion, or will it be the 25-year-old mother of the 1.5-year-old child and 3 times Olympian participant, Oksana Shushovutina? There in the red leotard. We'll see. Well, everything is pointing at Jelena Samolodchikova, of course. She has so much merits on this piece of apparatus. But we won't say anything before this competition is over. In the meantime, we can say that the bronze medal, third place, went to Jana Komorskova, as you could see on the list of results shown a minute ago. Fourth were Verona van der Leur, young 15-year-old Dutch girl. And fifth were Emma Williams. Number 6 were Ekaterina Lobashnyuk. 7 Lisa Brüggemann from Germany. And last place went to Denise Lopez, who never fulfilled her competition. Well, time so. Winners' final and the women's vault in Cottbus 2001. Oksana Shushubetina, first vault. Well, quite a good one. Not easy to land that vault. Handspring front, full twist.
Salto vorwärts gehockt mit ganzer Längenachsendrehung.
See in the slow motion, going into the tucked vault and doing a full twist there. Landing within the permitted area, I think. But this is the big favorite. Samolodchikova, Yelena. Showing already in the final, where she had 9.462 as an average of her two vaults, that she's in good shape. And she also won 2 weeks ago in Paris, the big competition there, France Telecom. So why not another gold medal for this girl? Nothing else would be good enough for her.
Gerät frei für Yelena Samolodchikova.
Here we go. First vault for Samolodchikova. Oh yes, stuck landing. Tsukahara with double twist. Little pike, I would say. Should be completely straight. Because I think she's lacking a little bit of speed here, entering the vault. But look at the landing, it's almost perfect. Look here, a little bit bent hips. There's the landing. And this is excellent, of course. Only one vault in the winner's final. It's all over. It's now up to the judges to decide. Will it be Samolodchikova to the left or Shushubetina to the right? Going up in the air, showing who is number one today. Samolodchikova, the big star of Russian gymnastics. I think she will be a strong contender for the all-around world champion title this autumn, when the competition will be in Ghent, Belgium. Of course, she has her two teammates, Korkina and Prudnova, still competing. We will see Korkina later on in the uneven bars. And here we go. Just as expected, Yelena Samolodchikova is the winner once again in the vault. Yeah, it should be like that. No other of the Olympic finalists from Sydney is here taking part in this final today. But still a very good starting field. Samolodchikova from Russia is a very good uneven bar worker, definitely. And the Chinese is always good. So Bai Junyu will be interesting to see. Tiny little Chinese girl.
Andreas Schweizer steht im Ringefinale. Und die Birgit ist eben erst
girls preparing themselves and the bar. There's in the black leotard is Verona van der Leur. We saw her becoming number four this event. No, sorry, at the vault before. And she's one of the favorites here. Must be, because she won the uneven bars competition in Paris 2 weeks ago. 15-year-old from Holland there. You can see her, Verona van der Leur. She will be a really big star this year. Korkina in her golden shining leotard.
And an den Ringen Silvester Cholani. Auch dort Maß aller Dinge. Dort erleben wir.
Looks quite fit. Korkina.
Durch den Strategen aus Ungarn. Und letzter im Feld dann in Ringen wird Jackson.
It will be nice to see her compete here.
Und gespannt darf man sein auf das Duell, vielleicht um die Spitze. Chorkina gegen Jelena Samolodchikova.
Here is Samolodchikova, her teammate. The Russian girls competing here without any coaches. They are coaching each other, actually. The girls are taking care of themselves, very experienced girls. That was the little Chinese Bai Xukov. Over to the uneven bars and Oksana Shushubitina. Girls' code of points nowadays are more similar to the men's compared to which has to be. Oh, what a pity. Missing her catch up there. Well, pretty much likely the code of points on for the men and for the women. For example, the starting value is 8.8 for both gender. The bonus part is 1.2 then to receive the maximum of 10. The girls though have 6 different apparatus specific requirements compared to the men's having only 5 on each apparatus. On the other hand, the men have 6 pieces of apparatus to master and the girls only having 4. Shushubitina there finishes her routine, had a fall unfortunately, which will take down the score quite a bit.
Mit ihrer langjährigen Trainerin Svetlana Kuznetsova aus Usbekistan.
Here's the dismount, double straight with full twist. It's quite a difficult dismount.
Heftig verändert werden muss. Andere Dimensionen müssen eingestellt werden.
Der Mann, der für Deutschland demnächst professionell weiterwertet, ist Dr. Jörg Fetzer.
Bai Chunji aus China.
Chunju Bai from China. Very short little girl, not in the Olympic team for China last year.
34 Kilogramm ist sie leicht.
Only 34 kilo of weight. And as you can see, excellent gymnast on the uneven bars. Oh, it's very, very nice. And a good dismount. Bei Chunju. Or Chunju Bei, you might say.
Sie war schon bei der Weltmeisterschaft 99 dabei, holte Bronze mit der chinesischen Mannschaft zu Hause in Tianjin. Gewann 4-mal bei einem internationalen Turnier im vorigen Jahr und erschien dann auch bei den
Olympischen Spielen.
Sie ist auch chinesische Balkenmeisterin und turnt mit einer spielerischen Leichtigkeit.
If I remember right, I would check it out.
Kennziffern an diesem Gerät. Trotzdem glauben wir zu erkennen, der Trend geht hin zum Frauenturnen.
Wow, good routine for Bai Chunju.
Hoffen wir alle und haben es gesehen. Anyway, Shushubitina 24, Dennis Lopez, die übrigens in Behandlung ist, die Mexikanerin, ärztlich betreut wird. Und wir sagen Ihnen sicher noch im Verlauf des Wettkampfes, dass alles okay ist. Wir erwarten die Wertung.
Waiting for the score for the Chinese.
Für Bai Chunji.
The second score on uneven bars.
Inzwischen blicken wir schon mal. Ja, die Tafel ist da. 8,95
for Chinese.
Erwertet ist Dr. Jörg Fetzer. Herzlichen Glückwunsch für die Auszeichnung.
Sag's nochmal. Die Siegerin des vergangenen Weltcups vor 14 Tagen.
Verona van der Leur. Now it's time to repeat maybe the great success of Paris 2 weeks ago, where she took the gold on the uneven bars. But she might be a bit nervous here, so unexperienced on senior level. She has had her success on junior level, but this is quite different. And in this starting field today, she had a very experienced Olympic champion of Svetlana Korkina. She had a little mistake there in the beginning, losing tempo. But oh no! And there she it's all gone. Well, maybe the pressure was a little bit too high after the success in Paris. Trying to repeat it here in front of the audience in Cottbus.
Sie sind hier der Faktor in dieser Konkurrenz. Das Risiko ist hoch bei der Dynamik des stufenbaren Turnens.
It should be a stalder and transaction to the high bar. But she missed it. She's doing it once again. That's a stalder. Half turn, another endo, and just another endo. So it should be. Well, it's a good experience for her. Rona van der Leur, double with double. Well, good landing and a good dismount. Still smiling, and it's good to see.
Ja, da hat sie doch am Ende noch mal ihr Können aufblitzen lassen und Frank Lauter lächelte und dachte sich so bei sich, na, wenn sie durchgeturnt hätte, da hätte es doch was werden können. Das nächste Mal, ganz sicher.
Mr. Double Tuck with Double Twist, also dismount.
Im Dezember ist sie ja gerade erst 15 Jahre alt geworden und ist in diesem Jahr Mitglied der niederländischen Nationalmannschaft. Ihr erstes großes...
Rona van der Leur, remember that name.
Seniorinnen, so komisch es klingt für eine 15,5-Jährige. Wir erwarten die Wertung in...
She became 15 only in December last year, so she's really quite young.
Andrea Coppolino vor. Wir warten aber noch auf die Wertung. Der Männer am Pauschenpferd und erstmals treten die jungen Damen in Aktion. Finalgerät Sprung. Wir bitten sofort, das Einturnen an diesem Gerät zu beginnen und wir stellen im Der war fünffacher Weltmeister, Olympiasieger, alles
First the score for Rona van der Leur, 8.9. And second place of the three so far.
Und jetzt der Kecki nach.
Jana Komskova. Non-even bars. Oops, having big problems there. Oh yes, losing the tempo, losing the speed. And she has to go down to take the deduction for a fall because she did not at all have the possibility to continue the routine after this tempo loss.
Wurde dort Achte. Im Vorjahr erreichte sie das Sprungfinale, so wie vorhin schon. Und
here comes a Stalder.
Teil 2 der Übung.
That's a blind half turn. And here it comes. There, she's struggling to get over the bar, but she's not. And she has to put the feet on the bar and jump down. Well, up again. Has to start the routine over again within 30 seconds. Still having some problems here, I would say. And this mount is okay, but otherwise, no. Wasn't the day for Jana on this piece of apparatus.
Wir blicken an die Ringe und sehen einen Mann aus dem Land des amtierenden Weltmeisters. Er ist auf dem Weg zu internationaler Klasse. Wir haben der Männer am Pausch. Im Kampfgericht übrigens eine gute alte Bekannte.
So we're waiting for Roshupkina. And might be so that the score for Jana Komskova has been discussed a little bit.
Nikolai Andrianov. Beispielsweise. Sie sitzt im Kampfgericht. Die Wertung jetzt für Jana Komroskova 4,40. Das war nicht einfach zu werten, das kann man glauben.
Nun am Jana Komroskova only 4.4 with that very short routine. Shortened. So yeah, big deductions and let's forget about Jana Komroskova in uneven bars and have a look at Olga Roshupkina instead. Because I think this will be something else. She was number 7 all around in Sydney at the Olympics. So she's definitely one of the best gymnasts in the world. She was number 6 in the Sydney Olympic final on uneven bars as well, so this piece of apparatus suits her quite well. This is Stalder on the low bar. And you got to have these changes from low to high bar and from high to low bar. You have to variate your routine, being outside the bars and between the bars and on the low bar and on the high bar. And the dismount is there, double with full twist. And she looks happy with that, Olga Rushabkina. Still haven't seen the really high scores on the women's side on uneven bars. But it's difficult now with the new code.
We know that. Kommen zustande, weil der zweite Teil der Übung nicht gewertet wurde. Und zwar wegen einer Zeitüberschreitung. 30 Sekunden hätte sie Zeit gehabt, wieder anzutreten.
We're also now receiving an explanation of Jana Komskova's quite low score. After her fall, she took more than 30 seconds before entering the piece of apparatus again. So the second part of the routine were not evaluated at all, because you only have 30 seconds before you have to remount the apparatus. And she took more than 30 seconds there, so unfortunately the judges stopped judging after the first part, with the effect of receiving only 4.4. We have one more, the German Birgit Schweigert, not to forget.
Dem Publikum am Fernsehbildschirm die Chance zum Live-Erlebnis. Und nun gerät frei für die deutsche Mehrkampfmeisterin des Vorjahrs, für Birgit Schweigert, Deutschland.
So Birgit Schweigert then, starting on the low bar, in transition to the high bar. And a nice pike Jäger salto. Ending with a tucked double front. Popular, of course, here in Germany.
Sie lächelt selten, aber sie hat gelächelt, die Birgit Schweigert. Sie ist mit sich zufrieden, wir sind's mit ihr auch. Tolle Leistung von
and,
Birgit Schweigert.
She looks like she's quite happy with this routine.
Und sie sagte, ich habe Lust aufs Turnen. Schön,
there's the Pike Jäger Salto.
Aufgaben des Deutschen Turnerbundes weiter als die erfahrenste zur Verfügung steht. Wir erwarten die Wertung und konzentrieren uns bereits jetzt auf das
Olympia-Duell, German Schweigert.
Ein auserwähltes Publikum, meine Damen und Herren. Wann sieht man gleichzeitig?
Sitting there in the kiss and cry corner,
Olympiasieger
Birgit Schweigert, waiting for her score, anxiously.
Als nächster dann der Ungar, der Herr der Ringe und die Königin des Stufenbarrens in unmittelbarer Folge. Die Birgit Schweigert-Wertung sehen wir zunächst.
And the score for Schweigert comes here. It's 8.975. It's actually the first place with that score, 8.975. Very good for Birgit Schweigert in this compared to the other ones.
Männer am Pauschenpferd. Und erstmals treten die jungen Damen in Aktion.
And now we have Svetlana Korkina, Queen of Bars, Queen of Women's Gymnastics. Absolutely the most popular gymnast in the world, I would say, Svetlana Korkina. And there's the Korkina move. She has two named after her, the uneven bars, Korkina 1 and Korkina 2. And there's the dismount. Well, looks like Svetlana Korkina still has some more to give in this piece of apparatus.
Svetlana Korkina,
almost without a sign in her face.
vielfache Weltmeisterin, Grand Prix Siegerin hier 95
schon in
Cottbus
so much merits on uneven bars.
Und zuletzt in Sydney.
And
es wurde einige Minuten
dauern. Quite a similar routine as in the Olympics. He has made some minor adjustments, I think, but the big moves are there still.
An den Turngeräten. Sie sehen die Punkte 9,475.
And the score is already ready for Korkina, and it's 9.475. Now we are talking about scores, 9.475, much higher than the other ones. The first one over 9. We're going to Yelena Samolodchikova from Russia, teammate with Svetlana Korkina, who just had 9.475 for her routine. That's something to challenge for Samolodchikova. She has already won gold on vault. Here comes, oops, that was a really new start, and I'm not quite sure it should be like that, because it looks like she missed one hand and did a half turn, not on purpose. We'll see that on slow motion, I think. Definitely a new start with a round off and going backwards on the low bar. Routine packed with difficulties from Samolodchikova.
Ganz schnell noch die Wertung von Jackson Kanukai 8,875. Sie sehen nicht nur die Tafel dort, Cholani und Jovtchev im Winners Final, sondern Sie sehen auch in die Zukunft des Turnens der Region in Cottbus.
And we had the score for Kanukai Jackson, the last one. In the rings, he had 8.875. That means that Cholani and Jovtchev will meet each other in the rings Winners Final. Only one more score to wait for on this rotation, and it's the score for Yelena Samolodchikova here, ending her bars routine. Should be at least coming soon. First, we have here on the screen the scores on uneven bars for women, the two Russians in a clear lead, Korkina and Samolodchikova in the winners final. Time for uneven bars, and this lady, Svetlana Korkina, first up, she's the beginner, and she had 9.475 in the final. Now it's time to repeat that if she wants to have the gold. That's, oh no! That's the mistake she had in the Olympic Games as well. It was the Stalder Katchev, wasn't it? Yes. Which she missed in the qualifications in Sydney. There. And she missed it twice in Sydney, but in the final she took it and also took the gold. Well, big mistake for Korkina. There's the Korkina transaction between low and high bar. And here comes the dismount. Double tuck for a full twist. Well, 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 my friends. The way is open now for Yelena Samolodchikova to maybe defeat Svetlana Korkina. She has all the possibilities. It's all in her hands, because Korkina has made her mistake. And after that, she's preparing the bar for her teammate and actually the big concurrent now.
Leonid Arkayev wird das mit Gelassenheit registrieren zu diesem frühen Wettkampfzeitpunkt.
That's the dismount once again. So now Korkina is helping Samolodchikova. Not only rivals, these two, also good teammates, as you can see. Yelena, what are you thinking right now? you have the possibility to defeat your friend and teammate, and maybe maybe the leading lady of the Russian team, Samolotchkova, is the next one. Definitely.
And
let's have a look at the start, the beginning for Samolotchkova, because it was quite different, I would say. She did a round off and going backwards up on the low bar. And she was struggling a bit in the final just before. Now we'll see it once again. There's Korkina. Here it comes, the start. Well, it's the same start. It should probably look like that then. Oh, no! Now, Samolotchkova as well is doing a big mistake here. And maybe she's thrown it already. Oh, no! She had it all there, and Korkina couldn't do anything else than laughing. What is she doing? She had it. She had the gold medal in her hands, Jelena Samolotchkova, but she blew it already in the beginning. And Korkina, yeah, she's laughing. What else could she do? She probably thought she would go home with only a silver medal here, but now it's wide open again. Actually, Samolotchkova had more problems than Korkina, so this is quite a different way of finishing a final, a winner's final, actually. There's a double pike, and Samolotchkova is shaking her head. She knew she had the possibility, but she blew it. And this is very rare. Two great gymnasts in the final, in a winner's final, against each other, and both of them are crashing their routines. Well, this won't be easy for the judges then. Look here, she's completely out of control here. She had some mistakes just before this part. So, what mistakes gave the most deductions? It's up to the judges now. And it's not at all the great quality you would like to have in a winner's final, but nevertheless, it's quite fascinating. And here are the girls. And who will know? They're not used to this situation, and they're not used to count their scores while having so big mistakes. So I guess none of them will know who is the winner now. And they're just really laughing. And of course, it's not a very important competition for them. Come so many big championships later on. So the super crashing Cottbus will be remembered as the epithet of this uneven bars final. The superstars in the super crash winners final. And the judges is having the biggest problems of all, maybe, because it takes some time here to deliver the scores. Well, here we go. And for me, it's wide open. No ID, actually. Here we go. And it is Korkina. Well, she's thanking the judges there, waving to the audience, and of course, she's appreciating the gold, but looks like she's not really thinking she deserves it. Another day of interesting finals coming up now. And we'll start with beam and vault for men. After that, the second rotation of today will be with the women's floor and the men's parallel bars. And then we are ending with the men's high bar final, as usual, the last event in Cottbus. So first up on the beam will be Olga Roshopkina from Ukraine, ready for competition very soon. Just adjusting the springboard.
Wir starten in den zweiten Finaltag mit der ersten Schwebebalkenübung von Olga Roshopkina, Ukraine. Es bereitet sich vor für seine zwei Sprünge. Tui Loda aus Dänemark.
So here we go, Olga Roshopkina on balance beam. Front walkover, aerial walkover, and a front side somersault. Another side somersault. Roshopkina was number 6 on this event 2 weeks ago when there was a World Cup competition in Paris in the middle of March. Here comes the dismount. It's a double tuck. And she qualified as number 4 for this final with a score of 8.725, Olga Roshopkina. Well, at the beam we have seen Olga Roshopkina and we have the score now. It's 9.05 for Roshopkina. When it's time for the next girl on the balance beam, it's Ekaterina Lubashnyuk. She was silver medalist on this event in Sydney last year. So she's the vice Olympic champion. That means, of course, a little bit of pressure on her. But also some kind of quality guarantee. This is a world-class gymnast on balance beam. Good, solid, acrobatic moves. Good balance shown there, which it must be. And here she's preparing for a difficult move. That's the half twist front forward. Front somersault, I would say. Oops, there's a little bit of balance miss. Remember, the beam is only 10 centimeters wide, 5 meters long. And there's the dismount, it's a double tucked. Well, quite good from Lubashnyuk. We'll see if it's enough to reach a winner's final where the gold and silver medal will be handed out. For Lubashnyuk, it's 9.125. Here comes the second Russian girl. It's time for Svetlana Korkina. She has a gold from yesterday on the uneven bars. Now it's time for next medal chase on the beam. And meanwhile, we are getting the scores for Filip Janev, and it's better than to elude all. It's 9.212 for Filip Janev. He's in the lead with 9.212. And now let's enjoy Svetlana Korkina on the beam. What's her shape on this event? Looks quite good so far. Oh, there she has a fall, unfortunately. That twisting back will have it on slow motion later on. Well, 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 that's half a point's deduction for that fall. Oh, that's okay. It looked a little bit bad in the beginning, but she handled it quite well. So this mount for Korkina, that's the, well, it's a 2.5 twist. Used to be a double twist, but now on the end, a 2.5 twisting back somersault. And, well, not the perfect one, you could say, without any problem. We'll see. Well, Korkina has done much better on balance beam. So the score for Korkina we're waiting for. The last gymnast on beam.
9,144. Sie sehen das Mittel beider Sprünge.
We have the score for Daniel Aumvig already. So let's have that one for Aumvig. 9.144 is the score. 9.144. Oksana Shushovetina is the next. And the score for Korkina then? Well, 8.4. Not a great score for her. 8.4 only for Svetlana Korkina. And I guess it will be no medal here today. But yesterday she had the gold on uneven bars. So, quite a good competition, though, for her. And for Shushovetina, this is her third final. She's in all four finals, 25 years old. A mother of a little baby born 1.5 years ago. And still competing on this level. Good front somersault and a back one. Another back somersault. Very popular gymnast, Oksana. Showing everybody that you doesn't have to be 15 years old to do gymnastics on a world-class level. And the dismount is okay. It's a double tuck backwards. And another day at work for Shushovetina. Gives her quite a good result here.
Sie ist die ausländische Starterin mit den meisten Teilnahmen hier
in Cottbus mit den meisten Siegen.
Comes the slow-mo of the front somersault, and the back tuck somersault, and another back somersault coming here. Straight run. Interesting combination for Shushu Vitina. When we are turning our eyes on to the beam, where Gabriela Wames from the Netherlands, from Holland, is the next.
Vertreterinnen aus dem Juniorenbereich nun rein in die Seniorenkonkurrenzen dieser Welt. Wir begrüßen.
She came to this final after qualifications with place number 7. Oh no, she has a fall already in the beginning. What a pity for Lames. 8.3 was her score in the qualifications. But that was enough to get into this final field of 8 girls. Another bit of wobbling. Fall again for Gabriela Wames. And when you once have started to fall down, it's very easy to fall another time or a third time, really. Getting unsure, thinking of the mistake, it's the worst you can do. She's down there, not very satisfied, of course, with these mistakes, but still, good experience probably to be in this final. From Paris Cura, we're going to Elizabeth Twiddle from Great Britain. Gabriela Wames, score was 6.875. Whoops. Problems in the beginning for the British girl. But she's on the beam. The balance problem there. The front somersault, and that's okay. Oh no, there is the fall we've been waiting for, I would say, because you have had some balance problems before. Now it was too much after that back somersault, the back straight to 2 feet. Landed out of balance, and the fall is coming directly.
Schade, da wurde es nichts mit ihm.
Well, not very happy. Looks like Elizabeth Twiddle.
Danke für das Turnen in Cottbus. So, meine Damen und Herren, ich bedanke mich für Ihre Aufmerksamkeit, dass Sie uns diesen würdigen Rahmen für uns geschaffen haben. Wünschen Ihnen weiterhin viel Spaß bei den Wettkämpfen und ich ergebe.
The beam now, little Chinese. Oh, beautiful. Bei Shunyu. She was actually a member of the 1999 World Champion team for China. Oh, rock steady there. So she has been on the senior team since 99. Even though she looks so small and tiny. Well, she is small and tiny, of course. With the head back. And then the dismount is coming up. There's a round of double tact. Good routine. Now it will be quite a different score, I would say, compared to the very low ones so far. Now we're getting higher, probably a bit over 9.
Gestern wurde bei Chun Jie vierte am Stufenwagen.
She was number 4 in the qualifications. No, she was number 3, sorry, with 8.9 only. Only one girl over 9 points in the qualification for beam, with the German Lisa Brüggemann in the lead with 9.2.
Balkenmeisterin des Vorjahres bei Chun Jie. China
Shun Yu by 9.375. Now is a good score finally on beam. 9.375 in the lead. Bei Shun Yu from China.
Danke für das Turnen in Cottbus.
And we're having a look at Lisa Brüggemann. The winner of the qualification competition Friday evening with 9.2 then. Highest score so far on beam is Bei Shun Yu in 9.375. And a good dismount for Lisa, and she's happy, of course. Another good routine as she did in the qualification. Might be a position in the winner's final with this score, but she has to be higher than Lobashnyuk, 9.125. She's Shun Yu Bai from China, and second is Ekaterina Lobashnyuk. These two girls once again competing now to determine who is the winner and who is the second one. First up on the beam is Lobashnyuk, silver medalist at the Olympic Games last year. A very special balance move there. Lubasniuk having 9.125 in the final, which qualified her for this winner's final. And we are starting all over again from zero. New routine, new chances for everyone. No, there she has a fall, Lubasniuk. And that opens the possibilities for the Chinese coming afterwards. Here comes her half turn front somersault. Deep concentration, and there it is. Except for the fall. Good routine. Just some minor mistakes, balance mistakes. And another one on the landing, a little bit under rotated, but quite well, except for the big mistake when she's falling down from the beam. Lubasniuk. Now it's in the hands of Bei Chunyu from China. The possibilities are there to grab the gold for the Chinese.
Wir verraten Ihnen die Punkte nicht. Schauen Sie, vergleichen Sie selbst. Und anschließend gibt es die besondere Einrichtung, den Fahrstuhl des Erfolges. Wer am höchsten fährt, ist die Siegerin. Ob das die kleine Bai Junjie ist, werden wir sehen. Sie, nun die zweite, wenn das Finale ist.
Here we have the Chinese, Bai Junjie.
Aus Peking.
Just a little girl, just a little body, but so much gymnastics inside. Nice start with a head spring. And she looks so steady on the beam. That's marvelous jump there with the back, with the head back. Well, very good combination with both feet together. Looks like she spent quite a lot of hours on the beam. But there, a little balance miss. She can't afford to fall down, because then it's very close again. Lubasniuk had a fall, half a point deduction. So, might be a gold medal here for the Chinese, if she's just standing on the beam for all the routine. And now she has only the dismount. Come on now. Stay on the landing. Oh yes, it's there. I think we have the gold medalist here, Bei Chunyu. She did hit her routine with just some minor mistakes, and the Russian Lubasniuk had a big fall. That might be the difference between these two girls today. Look here. Flip-flop, and a straight somersault. All of them with the feet together. Marvelous combination. And here comes the dismount, the double tuck.
Die
So, here they are, going up, and who is the winner? I think it's the Chinese, because she didn't have a fall, and yes it is, Bei Xunju. She is the gold medal winner in Cottbus. Takes the gold on the balance beam. Bei Xunju from China. Well deserved. And a popular winner. The floor. That's the last. We have to enjoy those girls who has qualified. First of all, Olga Roshopkina from Ukraine. A nice double piked. Olga Roshopkina went through her routine without any big mistakes as the first competitor on floor. There we have her double tucked. And waiting for her score.
Erster Starter für die Männer aus Frankreich, Benoit Carreau.
And comes there, 8.525. And we are watching Joanna Skipko from Poland. Floor. Nice routine from Skipko. First year as a senior for her. She was competing in the Junior Europeans last year, placed number 12 all around. And showing her ability here on the floor, only stepping outside the line there. Otherwise, good routine, good acrobatics for Joanna Skipko. First score on floor was Roshopkina's 8.525, something to aim for when we are watching now Verona van der Leur, an interesting young girl from Holland. She had the best score in the qualifications with 9.0. Straight with double twist. Difficult. Well, a nice routine. Another good performance from Verona van der Leur.
Verona van der Leur, vierte am Sprung gestern, sechste am Stufer mit Pech, da schlägt sie ab, ihr dritter Einsatz. Zettel Gui aus Frankreich, 8-1-5.
For Joël Ouellet from Canada. The score for Verona van der Leur was 9.15. And here goes the Canadian. Starts with a full twisting double back. And a triple twist. Unfortunately, for Joël Ouellet, new Canadian name. Remember her teammate Ludwig Furnon taking. No, sorry, it's not teammate, of course. Furnon is from France, but Yvonne Toussek, the Canadian floor specialist. Now comes another Canadian. Nice gymnast on the floor, Joël Ouellet.
Jetzt kommt der Mann, der Pechvogel der olympischen Saison. Europameister war er im Frühjahr am Barren. Und dann Pech in Sydney. Im Vorjahr Zweiter von Andreas Becker geschlagen.
We have van der Leur from Holland with 9.15. We are once again looking at floor, Lisa Brüggemann. We give you the score for Joël Ouellet. It was 8.85 when the German Brüggemann is entering the floor. Thank you. nice routine, very much appreciated by the audience, from the German Lisa Brüggemann.
Die Wertung am Band. Führung nun für den Europameister aus Slowenien 9,025 für Mitja Petkovsek. Im Jahr 2001 hier.
Here we have the best girls so far on floor. Rona van der Leer still in the lead. When we are seeing Oksana Shushubitina on the floor. Front piked. Shushubitina, Oksana from Uzbekistan, making her fourth final of this competition, 10 years after her international debut on senior level at the World Championships 1991 in Indianapolis. Still doing gymnastics at this very, very high level. It's amazing to see this 25-year-old Oksana Shushubitina. It's a good double pike there, a little bit under-rotated. And we are watching Gabriela Wammes from the Netherlands, second Dutch girl on floor. Oops, a little bit low on that, straightforward. The handspring double twisted straight front. Twist. But a nice routine, good tempo, nice popular music, which is appreciated by the audience. Gabriela Wammes. Lots of speed and energy in this exercise.
Petkovsek, der Europameister, und Zhao Zhen, im Moment noch Aspiranten fürs Winnersfeind. Gleiche Punktzahl. Aber jetzt kommt der zweite
Test. Triple Twist, not really finished. Under-rotated both the vault and the twist, actually. wait and see. Alexander Baltz now from Switzerland on floor. The score for Gabriela Vames were 8.2. Alexandra Baltz, actually second in the qualification with 8.825. Now in this final, out as start number 8. One more girl to go. Katarina Lubashnyuk is coming soon. It's a slow-mo of the 2.5 twist, well executed. Double pike, and there's the mistake. Jeru bounced from the floor, giving her a fall, unfortunately. Well, back to floor, and the last girl, Katarina Lubashnyuk. Now, at the moment, Verona van der Leur and Lisa Brüggemann are the two best girls. Lubashnyuk might want to be in the winners' final together with Verona van der Leur. Looks good so far. Here, a little bit different, a lot of dance parts from Lubashnyuk. There's a triple twist. Still a routine filled with difficult acrobatics along with a nice choreography. Well, this might be one of the best scores so far on floor, and it's important, of course, because the two best are now proceeding to the winners' final. Verona van der Leur are already there, either together with this girl, Lubashnyuk, or together with Lisa Brüggemann. So the last score in parallel bars, in the meanwhile, Yernar Yerimbetov, 9.137, it's the best score so far. So he's going to the winner's final together with Aljash Pegan. On the men's side, on parallel bars, Yerimbetov and Pegan in the winners' final. And here you can see Lubashnyuk, 9.125. She's second, and she's in the winners' final, racing against Verona van der Leur. The Netherlands against Russia in the winners' final on floor. Very interesting. Final to come. Lisa Brüggemann is a good bronze medalist, that's for sure, from Germany. And Joelle Ouellet from Canada is fourth. Shushu Butina, number five. And we are looking forward to the winner's final. Yes, to see who will take the last gold medal on the women's side. Time then for Verona van der Leur. Now she's ready. On the floor, first out. Challenged by Ekaterina Lubashnuk from Russia. Two girls of the new generation of gymnastics, especially this girl, first year as a senior. She became 15 just in December. Now she's on her first senior competition season. Oh, stepping out there, unfortunately. Taking a step out of the white lines, it's not permitted. Triple twist. Indeed, a lovely floor exercise from Verona van der Leur. Full of harmony, good body shape, good body positions, and well choreographed. Well, yeah, I think this is a real nice floor exercise. There's the triple twist. And watch out for this girl in the future. Maybe not already in the words this autumn in Gent in Belgium, but let's say in the Olympics 2004 she will be ready definitely to challenge the very best gymnasts.
Und WM-Erfahrung hat sie, 3 Jahre älter als die Niederländerin. Und bei Olympia 3 Medaillen, Silber im Team. Sprung, Bronze, Silber, Balken. Und jetzt wieder im Medaillenfinal, Ekaterina Lubashnuk.
And here's her rival today, Ekaterina Lubashnuk. With 3 Olympic medals from Sydney, she's now entering the floor from Russia, Lubashnuk. This looks like she's not in the mood to compete this music. Must have been some mistake here. Mistake that happens now and then when they put on the music to the wrong gymnast. There's Bruno van der Leur, waiting, anxious. So here we go, Lubashnuk. Starting with a double straight. With back 2.5 twist punch front. front somersault with 2.5 twist. Very, very difficult. And she's doing it well. Performing here with lots of self-confidence. Well, what a great finish of this competition on the women's side with two really lovely floor exercises. Chekaterina Lobashnyuk here doing a great performance as the last competitor on floor in the winners' final. Let's see what the judges thought then. Lobashnyuk or Van der Leer? Here we go, and it is the Russian girl, Yekaterina Lobashnyuk. She takes the gold medal, but a well-deserved silver to Verona van der Leer from the Netherlands. The Cottbus competition will be back next year. Thank you for this time, and hope to see you soon again in a gymnastics competition.